the Minister of Health. So first of all, let me thank the Asaba community for coming to this event in large numbers. And we thank our visitors for honoring our invitation.
Why are we here? What are we here to do? I will tell you that by telling you a very short story. Some years ago, while I was still a professor in the United States of America, I got a call from one of my colleagues that she had been appointed to a commission from the United Nations to visit Nigeria to advise the United Nations and the government of Nigeria what to do about the development and progress of the country. And so he wanted me to sit down with him and tell him some of the things I thought he should attend while he was in Nigeria. I arranged to have a dinner with him, and at that dinner I invited some of my colleagues. And I told him some of the things to look at in Nigeria. And one of the things I told him to make sure that he visited my home, my hometown, Asaba. 6 months later, he called me to say that he has completed his mission and would like an opportunity to tell me what he found and what he advised. So I invited him to another dinner, and some of my friends were there, we had to see. He told me many, many things. But I think I'll tell you briefly how many three of the issues I told him. He told me that he had been warned about traffic congestion in Lagos. I think he wanted to travel in Enugu on his way to Asaba. But he should leave his hotel room in time to catch the flight. And so on the fateful day, he left his hotel room on the island 4 hours ahead of the scheduled time of the flight. He said, but soon after leaving the island and getting to Abuja, there was a traffic jam. And after spending about 2 hours in that traffic jam, he decided to walk to the end and see what was the cause of the jam. So he trekked about half an hour and then reached the beginning of the traffic jam. And what did he see? Long queues on both sides of the road at the crossroad, and 2 cars were coming head on instead of keeping to their lanes, and the 2 cars stopped in the middle of the road, engine to engine. And that was the cause of the jam. And the people who drove the cars were not in the cars anymore. They had descended and they stood there threading insults, and crowd gathers complimenting them and clapping. And motorists were suffering on both sides of the country. Then he discussed and was amazed to see the suffering in Lagos. And in spite of the suffering, Nigerians were dancing and enjoying themselves. But I told him that that was not new news. They captured the celebrated song of Philanos and Putin. Suffering and smiling. Then he said he flew the new moon, winding roads for nature. When he approached on nature, he showed him a compound overgrown by trees. And he said that is where the famous Nnamdi Azikiwe was buried. And after that, he was an innovator on each other. But he said, so he left. And after leaving that compound, he took a very quick nap. 20 minutes later, when he woke up from his nap, he asked the driver, I thought Asaba was near the nature. Why bothered you when you went to Guinea? He said, Asaba is so small that you pass Asaba in this short nap. So, reverse, go back to Asaba. He was sleeping by women. Asaba, who houses Asaba? The information was correct, but his interpretation was wrong. I said, but that in the course of the war, the leaders of Asaba who owned those houses were massacred. But for the gallant women who worked so hard to educate those children that were left behind, we would have had no leaders in the generation that followed. So today, we are here to remember those dead leaders who were massacred during the war, and to celebrate and thank the gallant Asaba women who worked so hard to ensure that Asaba continued to progress and have the leaders in the next generation. That is the proper tradition. I thank you all for coming here today, honoring and fishing. I wish you all well. And at the close of this ceremony, I wish everybody a safe return to their homes and destinations. May God bless you all.